Hello and welcome to the Car Care Nut channel. In today's video, we're going to be talking about replacing the transfer case and differential fluid in all-wheel drive models. And we're going to briefly talk about the difference between trucks and all-wheel drive systems so you know what's what and what maintenance you need for your car. But before we get started, if you're new to the channel, welcome. Consider subscribing to the channel. Check out some of my other videos. If you are a returning subscriber, well, thank you so much for watching another one of my videos. Without further ado, let's get right into it. So a small overview before we get started. Let's identify what maintenance is needed for the all-wheel drive or four-wheel drive system. If you have a truck, basically a body on frame, a true four-wheel drive system, like 4Runner, like a Land Cruiser, like a Sequoia, and other models that have this kind of four-wheel drive system, you will have a front differential, a transfer case in the middle, and then a rear differential. In all-wheel drive models, or something like the Highlander behind me, RAV4, Camry all-wheel drive, Venza all-wheel drive, and etc., these models, they do have a front differential, but it's actually part of the transmission. So there's no service for that other than just the regular service on the transmission. But you do have a transfer case in the front that has gear oil, and you have a rear differential in the back that requires service. On all of these models, it is recommended that you replace that fluid every 30,000 miles or 3 years. Now, here's the truth version of that. You can easily go between 30,000 miles to 50,000 miles on the second replacement. The first replacement, I recommend you actually do it at 30,000 miles because you're gonna notice a lot of sediment on the magnet, and that is something recommended. On the second and third and fourth and whatever subsequent replacement, you're not really gonna see a lot of sediment on the magnet as much as the first time. On the truck side of things, you will want to replace it at 30 or less if you do heavy off-roading or heavy towing. Otherwise, you're good with the same recommendation. Having said that, I will leave a link in the description of this video where I discuss different kind of fluids and why they are important that you understand the difference of viscosity, GL5, GL4, whatever the case may be. But in this video, we're going to be focused on the procedure, not talking about the fluid. So after you've watched this video, maybe check out the other one so you can shop around for fluids and know what's what. Let's start with the transfer case first. We're underneath the car. This is your transmission right here. The engine is on the other side. Transfer case typically is attached to the transmission, a little bit to the middle of the car. This is a 15 Highlander that we're working on, just for your reference in case you have the same one. Most of the sizes here, let's talk about the sizes of the bolts. And let's talk about something very important as well. Some of them, specifically the Highlander, your RXs, they're going to be 24 millimeter drain plug and fill plug. Some of them, like the trucks, like your RAV4, will have a 10 millimeter hex. So one important thing about these, and I want you to understand the theory behind this so you would not make mistake with this and fill it from the incorrect spot. Your fill plug will always be at the same level or lower than your axle. I hope this makes sense, because if you fill the fill over the axle, you're actually gonna submerge that seal in fluid and it's gonna leak. That's always the case. That is how these are engineered. So I am saying this because some of the models, specifically your RAV4, we'll have another plug, and some of these Highlanders, especially the older ones, will have a plug at the top, and in some of them, that plug is very easy to access. You're going to think that is the fill plug, but that is actually a factory plug where they fill them. It just makes it easier for them. They fill a predetermined amount. Do not use a fill plug that is higher than your axle. In the case of this Highlander, in the case of most of them, there are a few that are different. The fill plug is right here. Kind of hard to see on camera, I know, but it is a 24 millimeter. It is right at the level of the axle. Your axle is right here. You're gonna look at it. It's the same level. We are good. That's what you want. Common sense, always take your fill plug first. You do not want to be in a situation where you drain the fluid. Now there's a problem taking your fill plug and now you can't take it out and you can't fill it. Now you're stuck. Always take your fill plug first. This is the case with every fluid you drain in this style. This is just we're gonna drain the fluid, we're gonna fill it to the top, and life is good. Let's go ahead and take out our fill plug. 24 millimeter on this one. We're gonna get a catch pan here to catch the fluid. Sometimes you will get some fluid that'll come out of the fill plug. This one did not have any. That means the level was correct, not slightly overfilled. And the last thing I will say, and this is more of a rust special. Now this car doesn't have this issue, but sometimes some of these plugs will be so tight, especially the 10 millimeter hex. If you have a RAV4, for example, they will order, especially the trucks. Here's a little trick for these. In case you have a drain or fill plug that is 10 millimeter hex that is stuck or looks very rusty, tap on it with a hammer lightly. Just tap on the face of it, not with high force, but just give it a four or five taps. That'll actually loosen it, and you'll put your hex. If your hex does not go all the way in, put your socket and tap it on it. That actually, that tapping will loosen it, and they'll come right out. So let's go ahead and drain the fluid. I have my catch can right here. We're gonna try to do this without making a mess. There it goes. We're gonna wait for the fluid to completely drain where we are down to a drip. We are car care nuts here. We're doing this ourselves. There's no rush. We're gonna wait until we get the most of the fluid out so we can get as much of the old fluid out. So now we got to the drip here. Before we close our drain plug, we're gonna do a couple things. First, we're gonna take the old gasket, discard it. I'm gonna talk about the gaskets in a little bit. We're gonna install this new gasket. But before we do, we're gonna want to clean the drain plug. I hope you can see the small amount of sediment that is on this drain plug. Let's see if the camera can focus. Right there. That is a normal amount. It's very typical after 30, 50,000 miles. Now this truck has over 100,000 miles. Let's go ahead and clean it. Just gonna take a towel, clean it. You can use some brake clean if you want, but I'll show you how the final result should look like. So we're all done with the cleaning. This looks much cleaner. Folks, if you mix the fill and drain plug, remember that the drain plug will always have the magnet. In most cases, we'll talk about this in a little bit. So we're gonna put the new gaskets here. Install it, tighten the drain plug. Let's talk about the gaskets real quick. This is called a crush washer. Here's a part number for that. This you will use on a lot of your all-wheel drive models for the front transfer case, for the rear differential. On the trucks, this will be the same gasket for your front differential fill plug, but not the drain plug. Some of these trucks will have a really big washer, has a bronze color. That's the one for the drain plug. I will leave the part number for here for that. And then for the transfer case on the trucks, you're gonna use an aluminum washer. I will leave the part number right here for that one. So these are the three styles. The 2014 and up Tundra will have a one-time use drain and fill plug for some of them. Some of them change at some point. So if you see that style, you have to replace that drain plug. The sealer comes pre-applied on it. So if you have that style, you have to replace these drain plugs. You gotta get them from the dealership. So now that we've gotten the fluid drain, we're gonna go ahead and fill it. There are multiple ways to fill it. I have some recommendations in my Amazon affiliate store for some pumps, for some transfer pumps. I'm just gonna use a generic one that just pumps the fluid out of the quart bottle into the transfer case until it overflows. So now I got my pump ready. One thing I will say, on the transfer cases, the fluid that you're adding, some of them, you'll have some products that are a pouch that's supposed to make it easier. That never really works on the transfer case. It works on some of the differentials. On the truck's transfer case, it does work because you have a lot more room. But here, it's really hard to get that pouch in here without making a mess. So just use a pump, you know, a hand pump, put it on the fluid bottle and just pump it in. So let's go ahead and do that. And I want to show you how you know when you are at the level. So here is the pump setup. I just got it in the bottle right here, just so you can see it. And we're gonna go ahead and start pumping it. So this is the point you wanna get to when you start getting flow like this. When it starts to overflow, pull your hose. So right now, we have the drip. We have filled it to the correct level. When it starts overflowing like this, we're gonna wait for it to stop, and then we're gonna install our fill plug. That has slowed down to a good amount. Let's put a new gasket on our fill plug and reinstall it. Now let's clean up, because differential fluid or gear oil is really not the best smelling fluid in the world. And some of it, in some of these cases, you will have some that goes in the exhaust. Just wipe it down, some of it will stay. If you want to use brake clean, go ahead. That'll help you clean it much better. But if you do, you're gonna smell it a little bit and it'll go away. Nothing I am too worried about, and you shouldn't be either. But try to be as clean as possible with these jobs. Some of the models, you'll make a big mess, and that's okay. But clean things as best as possible. Always work clean. So the rear differential. You notice these drain plugs are a little rusty. They're not terrible, but we're gonna give them a couple taps. This actually shakes them up, and now you get a better chance of removing them without a fight. And because they are rusty, the 10 mil hex does not want to go on. So what you're going to do, you're going to just tap it in to make sure it engages. We're going to loosen the fill plug first. That came right out. I didn't even put any force in it because we tapped on it. But here's another tip if you have the rusty ones. Life is always double hard when you're working on rusty cars. Don't let make sure you get your socket loose before you take it out, because if you take it out and that socket is stuck, you're gonna have a hard time loosening the socket from the plug. Here's the plug, do the same, strain the fluid. Just kinda start, see how it doesn't wanna go? Because if you go right now, you're gonna round it off. So start your socket and then tap it in place so it would engage well and you don't round it. And that tapping actually helps loosen it up, where I am barely putting any pressure on it and it just comes right out. Otherwise, they're gonna be really hard to remove. There we go. Let's go back. Let's drain the fluid. I got my pan right here. Let's go ahead and drain the fluid. Same thing, we're gonna wait for it to completely finish. We got the same thing on the drain plug. Got a little bit of sediment here, which we're gonna clean up. And we're gonna wait for it to completely drain. While this drains, I'm gonna clean the drain plug from sediment on it. So now we're down to a drip. Let's go, I put a new washer already, and we cleaned this really well. Right there, see that has no sediment. Also, the magnet is a drain plug. One thing, folks, that I might have not mentioned in the beginning, if you own a truck like 4Runner, Tundra, etc., and you're doing the transfer case will not have a magnet on the drain plug. So in that case, it doesn't matter which one is which, they're both exactly the same plug. But on the ones that have a magnet, the magnet will always be the drain plug. That way it's lowest and it can capture any metallic objects that collect. Let's tighten this guy. So now let's fill the fluid. Folks, I'm using a pouch here. You just gotta cut the tip here, get the seal on inside, and you're ready to go. So let's go for it. Let's fill out the differential. Don't push the pouch too hard, because then it'll overflow, because it'll give you actually a false reading. So you gotta be very careful with this. See, this is a false reading. You're just overflowing it. So take your time until you get steady flow. Don't push the pouch too hard, because then you're gonna overflow it. I think we are at the level. Just gonna double check, take your time. There we go. That is a steady flow out of this thing, not the false reading that we were seeing earlier. So now let's let it finish draining. We're gonna take the gasket off the fill plug, put a new gasket. I hope you can see the drip really well. That is a steady drip. Look how long it took. That means that we are actually at the edge of of where the fill plug is. So now let's wait for it to drain and stop to a drip, and then we'll install our fill plug and we're all done. And while we are here, I want you to notice how the fill plug is almost at the same level or just below the axle. Here's your axle. This is what we talked about a little bit ago. This is always this case with everything, because this style where you drain then fill until it reaches the edge of the bottom of the fill plug, if you put it over the axle, you're actually going to have the seal right here submerged in fluid, and it's going to leak. And this is what happens when you overfill these. They will leak. Now we've gotten down to a drip. Let's install our fill plug. Tighten it down. Let's clean things up as best as possible. So there you have it, folks. That was a simple process, very DIY friendly. But let's answer some frequently asked questions from my viewers about this. Let's first talk if this process is too complicated, you don't have the space, whatever the case may be, how much should you expect to pay a mechanic to do this? So typically, and this is the max labor time you're going to expect to pay, is half an hour per differential or transfer case. So in the case of the Highlander behind me, it has a front transfer case and a rear differential. The highest you will pay is half hour per, so 1 hour total. If you have a truck, so you have a front differential, transfer case in the middle, and then rear differential, you can expect to pay as high as 1.5, but not higher than that. The other frequently asked question is the sediment on the magnet. Is there a break-in period? Should you do it at 1,000 miles, 5,000 miles? No, because at 30,000 miles, the sediment is more than the subsequent replacement, but it's not excessive. So that's okay. There's no break-in period for these that you need to replace it earlier. If you want to replace this fluid earlier, that's up to you, but it could be overkill. And if you're doing it, these fluids are not expensive. You're doing it yourself. You know, it's not a giant expense, but 30,000 miles on the first replacement, and after that, every 30 to 50, and you're all set. I hope this video is helpful and informative. I hope you learned something new. If you like it, consider giving it a thumbs up. If you're not a subscriber, consider subscribing to the channel. Check out some of my other videos. Until the next video, folks, may the Lord bless you and keep you, and you have yourself a wonderful day.